kids! Today's story is about a face-off between two opponents. Although one was smaller than the other, he was able to claim victory with God on his side. So keep on listening to find out how this story plays out. Our story begins between two groups of people, the Philistines and the Israelites. These two groups weren't friends. In fact, they were about to go into battle with one another. The Philistines occupied one hill, and the Israelites were on the other hill. Only a valley separated the two peoples. The Philistines were hardly worried about the battle that was on the verge of beginning, because they had a secret weapon. They had their champion, Goliath, a giant. Goliath said to the Israelites,
"Hey you Israelites, choose a man and send him to battle with me. If he will fight with me and kill me, we the Philistines will become your servants. But if I beat him, then all of you Israelites will be our servants. Today I defy the armies of Israel. Give me a man and let's fight each other."
The Israelites was very scared.
"Oh no! What should we do? This is scary! We can possibly beat Goliath? He's a giant! Just look at him! Oh no! We are going to become slaves of the Philistines!"
You see? Goliath was extremely tall, 6 cubits and a span or 9 feet and 9 inches. His helmet and armor were all made from bronze. He carried a bronze javelin or spear too. Can you imagine how big and menacing Goliath looked? No one was brave enough to face Goliath, the menacing giant. For 40 days and nights, Goliath took his stand, but no one from the Israelites would fight him. But little did Goliath know that his match would soon come. Jesse, the father of David, told him,
"David, my son, bring this roasted grain and 10 loaves of bread to your brothers Eliab, Abinadab, and Shammah at their camp on the battlefield. Don't forget to give this 10 cheese to their commander. Make sure to check on your brothers and bring back some good news about them for me."
David said, "Where will I find my brothers, father?" Jesse told David,
"They are in the valley of Elah, with Saul and Israelite men fighting against the Philistines."
So early in the morning, David left his flock of sheep to another shepherd and went on his way to do as his father told him. When he arrived at the battle camp, the army was going to their battle positions and shouting their war cry. The Israelites and Philistines had lined up and faced each other. David quickly ran to find his brothers. Goliath told the Israelites again,
"Today, I defy the armies of Israel. Give me a man. Let's fight each other."
The Israelites were so scared.
"It's Goliath. He's just so scary. Let's run away. Who is brave enough to face their giant? He keeps coming out to defy Israel.
I heard that the king will richly reward the man who will kill Goliath. He will let him marry his daughter, and his family won't have to pay taxes anymore."
David asked,
"What will happen to the man who will beat this Philistine and remove this disgrace from Israel? Who does this giant think he is, that he should defy the armies of the living God?"
One of the Israelites said,
"Like I said, he will be rewarded with riches by the king and given the king's daughter in marriage.
Oh, and his family will be tax-free.
Eliab asked David.
David, what are you doing here? You surely just came here to watch the battle. He was so very angry.
And David said,
What have I done? Can I talk?
Now, King Saul heard about David and what he said to the man and called him. David said,
Let no one be discouraged because of Goliath. I, your servant, will go and fight him.
And Saul said to David,
You cannot fight him. You are young. He has been a warrior since he was young.
David said to King Saul,
I am a shepherd of my father's flock. I was able to fight and kill both a lion and bear that come to attack my sheep. The Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will rescue me from the hand of this Philistine.
King Saul said to David,
Go, and the Lord be with you. Here, wear my armor, David.
David said to King Saul, I cannot wear this. I am not used to this heavy armor.
So David took off the armor and went to the stream. He chose 5 smooth stones and placed them inside his shepherd's bag. With his sling in his hand, he walked to Goliath. Goliath didn't like David. A boy? The Israelites had sent a boy to fight him? Was this a joke? Goliath said.
Curse your God! I will feed you to the birds and wild animals!
And David said to Goliath,
You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hands, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head. This very day I will give the carcasses of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. All those gathered here will know that it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves. For the battle in the Lord's, and he will give all of you into our hands.
As Goliath moved closer to attack,
David ran and took out a stone from his bag, slung it, and hit Goliath on the forehead. The stone sank into the giant's forehead, and he fell face down on the ground. The Philistine giant was dead, all because of a stone and a sling.
David took Goliath's sword and cut off the head of the giant. Seeing this and realizing their champion had lost, the Philistines became afraid and ran away, but the Israelites ran after them and fought them. The battle had been won because of the ultimate source of strength, God. Do you know why Goliath was beaten? The sling and stone may have helped, but really, it was because of God. God is our ultimate source of strength. The most powerful man on earth is no match for God. God is the strongest, most powerful, smartest, and most perfect one out of anything and anyone. Did you know, aside from being our source of strength, we can find salvation in God. God sent His only Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross so that we could be forgiven of our sins. Jesus took the punishment that was meant for us so that we wouldn't have to spend eternity away from God. Because God hates sin, Jesus is the only way for us to spend eternity with God in heaven. What we have to do is say sorry to God. Say sorry for our sins so we can live with Him in heaven forever and ever. We should ask God to forgive us for the bad things we did. And we should ask Jesus to come into our hearts as our Lord and personal Savior. Are you ready to do this and be with God and Jesus forever and ever in the beautiful place He prepared for us called heaven?
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of